morning. Wow, that was great. Welcome to Treasured VBS. This is going to be an amazing week, and I am so glad you're here. Are you guys glad you're here? Okay, I cannot even tell you how much fun we're going to have this week. Are you ready? Okay, well, first, I need to introduce myself. My name is Miss Jennifer. Can you guys say hi, Miss Jennifer? And sometimes I'm going to go away, and I'm going to come back, and I'm going to be Dr. Diggingstone. So don't get confused, okay? Usually Dr. Diggingstone wears a hat, okay? Okay, you'll see. Now, this week, we have so much fun planned for you so that we can find out all about how we are God's priceless treasure. And we are going to have Bible stories, and we are going to have a lot of fun games and some really yummy snacks. We're gonna sing to the Lord, worship songs. We are gonna find out just how great our God is. We're gonna have so much fun learning about the Lord. We're gonna make new friends. You ready for that? Okay, and as you came in to a song that is our theme song, because our theme this week is called Treasure, and as you can tell, we're right here by an ancient temple, and we are going to see if we can figure out what the true treasure is. And so our song is called Priceless Treasure. And treasure is valuable, isn't it? It's worth a lot. We're gonna find out how we are worth a lot to God. Okay, so now I want to introduce our worship team. Are you ready? Okay, welcome Emma and Haley and Julia and Sienna. Okay, these girls are gonna teach you all of our songs, and they're gonna teach you hand motions. So get ready and stand up.
Priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am His, and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure. I am a priceless treasure. God knows.
I am a treasure.
of God. I know that I am loved. He hears me when I pray. He always makes a way. I am His and He is mine. And I am the prize He came to find. I am a priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am His and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever.
I am a treasure.
I really, really think it's going to be a marvelous, marvelous Monday. I have to tell you a little story. I was sitting in my kitchen on my fourth cup of coffee, and I got a phone call, the best phone call you could ever get. They asked me, would you like to assist? Would you like to come alongside and help the very, very famous Dr. Diggenstone? And I said, does Tarzan swing through the jungle? Of course I want to help Dr. Diggenstone. Where is she? I've been looking and looking for...
Dr. Oh! Watkins, I presume. I'm so glad you've chosen to be my assistant for this adventure.
Oh, it's such an honor. I can barely contain myself. And what have you got there? Oh, I have to tell you first that Dr. Diggenstone, I dig that name, is world famous and the finder of fabulous fortunes everywhere.
Yes, in fact, I am a
famous Oh, my. Oh my.
And the lost city of Cornucopia.
Cornucopia.
Although I'm having a little trouble finding my cell phone at the moment.
Oh, cell phone, schmell phone. She'll never get reception in the jungle. What is she thinking? Anyway, let's proceed with our great adventure. Today, you and I...
We are here because we are looking for the treasure.
The treasure.
And lucky for us, I have my trusty treasure.
Yes. Yes.
So I didn't pack my way through the jungle to miss out on the treasure.
You know, there's going to be plenty of treasure. Enough treasure to share with everybody.
Share? I have no plans of sharing the treasure.
Oh, but Dr. Diggenstone, I dig that name.
What? I have everything I need. My robe, my gloves, my mantle, and my...
Well, I see. She's really prepared. But this is going to be more challenging than I thought with the famous doctor in the house. Doctor, so I took a pause, I got a deep breath, and I was thinking, just thinking that
maybe... You are not paid to think. I will do what I can to help
Oh, come on. Anyway, you and I together, we can conquer. We can do these great things having to do with treasure. But I just don't know how to proceed.
Wait, were you trying to say something?
Well, I'm just trying to say that there is real treasure out there.
Yes, and the treasure must be around here somewhere.
Oh, Dr. Digginstone. I dig that name. Dr. Digginstone, what are we gonna do?
Of course I can hear everything you're saying, but, I thought I was the only one who knew about the treasure.
They are very important people. They are called the That. The T-H-A-T.
That?
That. The Treasure Hunting Adventure Team. Oh, Dr. Digginstone, I don't think she ever listens to me. I don't think she ever hears me. And we won't be a distraction, I promise.
And Dr. Digginstone, what did you think of them? Okay, well, we are going to go off to our classes and start the fun, but I want to tell you something. We are going to be on the lookout for God today. Okay, we are going to see what we're going to look for, what we're going to call God sightings. Okay? Let's see if we can see things that God does. I already saw one. I saw that you guys all came today. That was really special, and God did that. All right, so something special like a friend that's kind to you, or a beautiful flower, something that shows our God. Are you guys ready for the day? Let's go!
Welcome! Welcome to Vacation Bible School! Hey, what grade is this? Wait, what? Second and third, okay. 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 How are you guys? I am so excited to be back at Vacation Bible School. Is this anyone's first time ever coming?
No.
To Vacation Bible School.
Maybe.
I can't wait. I'm so excited that you guys all came. Let me introduce myself. My name is Teacher Williams, and welcome to my office. So in the sanctuary, you guys are probably learning. They're searching for treasure, right? Okay, well, this is where all the work gets done. They don't go out until I look at maps and I do research and I help find treasure with them. But I do the studying here, and I can't wait to share with you what I have found and what I have discovered. There's snakes everywhere, so just... That's just being, it's just part of being in the field.
A snake in a mouse trap? Okay. A rattlesnake?
you're learning this week that you are God's treasure.
Oh, okay.
So as I am searching for treasure, I'm going to share with you what I have found. Shall we start?
Yeah.
Should we get right in?
Can you share your treasure?
Okay, let me ask you guys a question. And let me just tell you a hint. I like quiet hands. Does anyone know what a prophet is? Who can tell me what a prophet is? Quiet hand. What's a prophet? What's a prophet, Emily? What's a prophet?
Oh.
Do you know? The Old Testament talks about it. What's a prophet?
It's someone who...
It's a messenger from God.
Yes. Yeah.
So God would speak to the prophet, and the prophet would go give a message to the people, to God's people. Okay, so maybe you've heard of this prophet. His name is Samuel. Have you heard of Samuel the prophet? Okay, so our story begins in the book of 1 Samuel. And it says here that Samuel... he was overseeing God's people. And you know what the people started doing? They said, give us a king. We want a king. And he said, I don't think that's really a good idea, but I will go talk to the Lord. And you know what the Lord told Samuel? He said, God's people, they have rejected me as their king. They didn't want it. They said, no, thank you. That's what God said. That's what God told him. He said, you know what? They're asking for a king. And they continue to say, we want a king over us. Then we will be like all the other nations with a king to lead us and to go before us and fight our battles. They wanted to be just like everybody else around them. That's what they wanted. When really God was saying, but I'm your king. In fact, in the very beginning of this book that we call the Bible, what's the very beginning of this scripture?
Genesis
1:1, it says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. He is our creator king. God was their king. And they said, no, we want a real king, just like everybody else. And so, God heard, and he selected somebody. Have you heard of King Saul?
Yeah.
That's one character in our story. So Saul, it says here in 1 Samuel 9, something about Saul. Did you know this? It says he was an impressive young man without equal among the Israelites. That means there was none like him. And you know what else it says? It says he was a whole head taller than the others. This guy stood out. He was a big guy. So he was selected to be king over Israel, over God's people. Now, it says that Saul messed up. And it says that he was disobedient. And so God sent Samuel to him and says, you acted foolishly. Have you ever acted foolishly?
Yes.
We do. We mess up. And so Saul messed up. But let me ask you, if you, in your home, if you are disobedient, are there consequences?
Yes. Sometimes.
Put your hands down. There are consequences when we don't obey. And you know what? King Saul, he could give all the commands through his land, but guess what? God, our creator king, had consequences for him because he didn't obey God. And you know what it says? It says, now your kingdom, you acted foolishly. So now guess what, Saul? Your kingdom will not endure. It's not going to last. The Lord has sought out a man after his own heart. That means God found someone whose heart loves the Lord, trusts the Lord, seeks after him. God found him. And it says that he is going to be the new king over people. He's going to lead the people because you have not kept the Lord's commands. That's why. Consequences of his disobedience. So you might know this king, a man after his own heart, and his name, this King David. It was David. So Samuel went to go find him and anoint him the new king, just like God told him to do. So he was obedient. And you know what it says? It says that he went to the house of Jesse and he saw his sons, and they looked like king material. And the Lord said, no, not that one. No, not that one. And he's like, Jesse, what's going on? Are these all your sons? And he says, well, there's the youngest. Is anyone the youngest in the family? Is anyone young? So do you get called the baby of the family? David was the youngest in the family. He wasn't the big brother. But yet God was looking at what? His heart. He was looking at his heart. God looks at our hearts. Not what we're wearing. Not how we do our hair. God wants our heart to talk to him, to love him, to inquire and ask about him.
To know him.
So the Lord picked David. So Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his big brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came upon David in power. David had power. Now, David did not automatically move into the kingdom and take the throne over right that day. It was going to be a little while later. So you still have Saul, the king, and guess what? Saul became still more afraid of David, and he remained his enemy the rest of his days. It gets even worse. It says Saul told his attendants to go kill David. Yeah, Saul wanted that. He ordered it. He went out looking for him. In fact, he went out looking for him so much that guess what David did? Did David say, hey, maybe we should just go have a burger and we'll talk it over? There wasn't. But who doesn't love In-N-Out? I mean, come on.
Yeah.
So what do you think?
I love In-N-Out.
What do you think David did?
He ate a burger.
What do you think David did?
He punched him in the face.
He ran.
No.
God. Yes, he did not hit him. He did not hit him in the face. You know why? You know why he didn't go fight? Because he respected Saul, because God anointed Saul as king, and David respected that. So he ran away. He ran away into the desert. In fact, he ran away so many different times because King Saul was after him. He would hear, oh, I heard David's over there. Okay, men, let's go. And they would chase after him. And David had to keep running from him and running from him and running from him. Now, don't you think that would get kind of lonely? He had to leave his wife. He had to run away. Now, he had a group. He had some men. He had soldiers with him. In fact, it says that even though when David was out there running from Saul, he still protected people. He still stood up for people. But you know what he did before he did that?
What?
He asked the Lord first. He prayed. How many times do we consider what God wants before we act and do something? Do we think about what God wants for us or ask God what the right thing is so that we don't do the wrong thing? That takes
trust.
That takes obedience. And so we hear that David hears of a town being attacked by the Philistines. And so he wants to go. He inquires of the Lord, should we go? And God says, yeah, you should go. And David said, okay, come on, man, let's go. We're going to go fight and we're going to save them. And the men were like, we don't want to go fight. We're already running from our lives, and we're going to go fight the Philistines? And you know what David did? He said, not that's a different story. He said, okay, guys, I'm going to go ask the Lord again. And he asked the Lord again. God is so patient with us. Sometimes we could question things, but you know what? He wants our heart. And as long as we're honest and we go to him, he is so thankful that we come to him. And you know what? He didn't yell at David and say, I told you to go. He says, you know what, David? I have given them into your hands. So basically, he's going to go fight and he knows that he's going to win. God told him. He said, go. You're going to succeed because God was protecting him. He was protecting him because God chose him to be the anointed king. God, he saves his anointed. And so they go off and they fight. And then guess what happens? Guess who heard about David winning this fight?
Saul.
King Saul. And King Saul says, I know where David is. Let's go, men. And they go. In fact, it says Saul was going along one side of the mountain, and David and his men were on the other side, hurrying to get away from Saul. And as Saul and his forces were getting closer and closer to David, ready to capture them, a messenger came to King Saul and said, the Philistines are in our land. Let's go. So King Saul stopped pursuing David. He was so close to catching him, but he went back because his own land was getting taken over. So he left and he went to the Philistines were raiding his land. And so then Saul broke off his pursuit of David and went to meet the Philistines. And David, it says, whew, he went up and he lived in the strongholds and in the caves and in the desert. He was kept safe, but he didn't get to go home yet. Now I got to ask you a question. We are not kings and queens, are we?
No.
But we have something very common with Saul, King Saul. Saul disobeyed. And you know what? We disobey too. Just a minute, we're almost done. We disobey too. And that, it makes God sad when we disobey. In fact, when God in the beginning, he's our creator, God, King. He created all things. And it was perfect in the garden.
Until Adam and Eve.
Until sin entered the world. And the problem with the sin is that it separated them and us from God. Because God is where? God is in heaven. And something cannot be in heaven with God. You know what it is? It's sin. Did someone say sin? Sin cannot be in heaven. But wait a minute. The scriptures tell us that we have all sinned. We all fall short of the glory of God. We're not perfect. We've all sinned. So how do we get to be with God in heaven? God had a plan, and his plan was Jesus. Jesus is always the right answer. His plan was Jesus. Now Jesus, hold on. Jesus was perfect. He did not do anything wrong. He did not break God's commandment. And yet, you know what? He took the consequences of everyone's sin. Yours, mine, everyone who lived. He took that punishment for us so that if we believe that he's God's one and only perfect son and that he died, but he did not stay dead, he rose again, and he resides where right now in heaven? At God's right hand. If we believe and trust and want him to be our savior, we become a part of that family. That's how in the next life we get to spend all eternity with God in heaven. The roads are paved with gold. There's so much we don't even know yet, but he loves all of us, each one of us. And Jesus is our way. In fact, you know what the Bible says? I didn't write it. It says that Jesus is the only way. He is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. So when we ask Jesus to be our Savior, it says that we're made a new person. We are a new being, but we're not just, I am a great new person. No, it's in Christ. We are a new creature in Christ. And you know what? Hold on, we're almost done. It says here about Christ, it's in Jesus who are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. We not only are you treasured by God, this is so cool. Hold on, hands down. Not only are you treasured, God looks at you. When Jesus takes our sin away, we are washed clean. And God looks at us like a perfect, beautiful treasure. But you know what? We also have treasure. And it says that it's in Christ. That is hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Now, can I show you something that I found? In all my research, in all my books that I've read, and all the things that I have accumulated and found, can I share with you my favorite thing?
Yeah! Best thing.
Can you help me, Benjamin?
Yes. Jesus!
This, yes, that's always the right answer. Hold on, I'm going to show you guys, sorry. I'm going to show you. Be patient. This is my favorite treasure I'm so excited about. Will you have a seat? Have a seat. Will you please get this for me, Benjamin? Will you please get that for me? This is my favorite treasure to share with you guys.
The Bible.
The Bible. And can I share what makes me so excited about this? And this treasured VBS?
It's golden.
It says in the Old Testament, hold on, sit back. I'll show you guys. In the book of Proverbs, it says that if you search for it, as for you're searching for silver and gold, that you will find, if you search for it as for treasure, which is what I do in my office. I'm looking for that treasure. It says that you'll find it. And it's the it's the wisdom of God that is the treasure. Now, what is the wisdom of God?
Treasure.
It's his word. It's the Bible. And we have that treasure. So with Jesus, hold on, have a seat. Scoot on back.
We can live eternally.
We get eternal life in heaven with God. Okay, not just leave that there. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So, can I read you in the Old Testament? This is what God thinks of you, okay? For you are a people holy to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you out of all the peoples of the face of the earth to be his people. It says his treasured possession. He looks at you as treasure. You're his treasure. You're treasured by God. So just like Saul, we have sin. But just like God chose David, God also chose Jesus, his one and only son, to pay that price, to get rid of our sin, so that we can be shiny, clean jewels and be with him for all eternity. Isn't that awesome news? Isn't that so cool? Isn't that so cool how these old stories, we can relate to them. These are just like us, these stories, these people. Okay, so we're going to scoot back, please. I'm going to end with, scoot back. We're going to end with a verse. And guess who wrote this verse?
God.
Jesus.
God.
Okay, this is written by King David himself. And you know how he kept, it's a fake scroll. Okay, so you know how he kept running?
Did he really write it in real life?
You know, this is from the Bible. This is from the Bible. And it's from the book of Psalms 86. It says, bend down, O Lord, and hear my prayer. Answer me, for I need your help. Protect me, for I am devoted to you. Save me, for I serve you and trust you. You are my God. Listen closely to my prayer, O Lord. Hear my urgent cry. I will call to you whenever I'm in trouble, and you will answer me. He knew that even though it was hard and he was struggling, he knew that his God was going to save him and protect him. And we can have that too. When we have Jesus. Okay. We're going to go ahead and pray. Now we're going to close our eyes and bow our head, and we're going to be really quiet, because when we pray, we're praying to a God in heaven who is sitting on his throne.
So
So he deserves our quiet heart right now. And I'm going to pray. Everyone close your eyes. Dear Lord, I just thank you so much for Vacation Bible School this year and for all the children who attend here. Thank you for your word that show us stories that are so similar to us, Lord, and how you just want our heart. You want us to love you back. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. I pray for all the hearts here that they would know you this week. And if they don't know you, I pray that they would come to know you and just love the gift of Jesus that you give. Please be with them for the rest of the day in safety, in worship, with family and friends, and they would just share the good news. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
So you guys having fun? Okay, let's get started here. Okay, I want to remind you that when we're done here, we're going back to our classrooms, okay? And also, teachers of the little ones, you're going to go out first, okay? Couple of reminders there. Okay, so I'm wondering if anybody had any God sightings. Any God sightings today? Something amazing God did? Sorry, Jim, I changed it up. Yeah. We're going to take one right now. Raise your hand again. Yep. Wave your arm. I'm pointing to you. Yep, that's the one. What did God do that was amazing today?
This is awkward.
Everyone listen.
So we saw animals in the sky.
You saw an animal?
Yes, we saw animals.
You saw some animals?
Yeah.
God's creation. Everybody clap. That's great.
We saw love from death.
Okay, be thinking about it, because I'm going to ask you at the end again, okay? But right now, we're going to welcome our worship team. So everybody stand up.
Priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am his and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure. Came to find. I am. I know that I am loved. He hears me when I pray. He always makes a way. I am his and he is mine. And I am the prize he came to find. I am a priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am his and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure.
Thank you. I call them the treasure hunting adventure team.
Have you and your adventure team had any luck finding the treasure?
Oh, I'm so excited to tell you. I think we have.
Wonderful news, great news.
Dr. Digginstone, I dig that name. What have you got there? What is that?
This is my one-of-a-kind Dr. Diggingstone patent-pending treasure tracker.
A treasure tracker. How cool is that? So how does it work, Doctor? Tell us.
Oh, well, you see what I'm doing. I'm looking for the treasure.
Looking?
And you just point it where you think there's treasure. And then it draws you to the treasure.
Whoa!
Oh, no. Something must be terribly wrong because... Do you have gold in your boot?
No, there's no gold in my boot.
There must be a malfunction.
Oh, Doctor.
Let me try again.
There she goes again. Do you think it's gonna work? Oh, my goodness. Is it working?
Oh, something's wrong. Did you see what it did?
Is there a malfunction?
You know, I think it must need batteries. Did you bring some batteries?
Batteries, schmatteries. There's no batteries out in the jungle. Dr. Digginstone, I just dig that name.
Well, never mind that for now.
Well, you just don't seem to be really listening to me. I don't think Dr. Digginstone even hears me.
Dr. Watkins, are you trying to say something? Just spit it out.
Well, I am trying to say something, but it just... She gets me so flustered,
I hear you. Well, anyway, according to my map, there is a special code that says we must have the exact phrase in order to get into the temple.
The exact words to open the temple doors? Well, what do you think those words are?
Well, I have an idea. Why don't you ask that?
Does anybody have an idea what those words might be? Yes, you in the pretty dress. She says maybe open sesame? Treasure? No, not treasure. Yeah. No, not treasure. What about... Say it again. God knows you. What else? What else could it be?
Okay,
God
well,
hears you.
That's very peculiar. Adventure team, now everyone must be quiet. Okay, I suppose we could try it.
Oh, yeah.
Even though I don't think it will work. Okay, everybody, on the count of three, God knows you. Ready? One. Two, three.
Well, should we try something else, Dr. Digginstone?
We'll try God hears you. Ready?
Yes.
But I don't think it's going to work. Ready? On three. One, two, three.
God hears you.
Let's try mine.
Okay.
I have an idea. Let's try mine. Ready? We're going to say bibbidi bobbidi boo.
Oh, yes.
Ready? On three.
Wait.
One, two, three. Bibbidi bobbidi booth. I know.
She has another idea.
I heard someone say it out there. Open sesame.
Good idea.
On the count of three. Ready? One, two, three.
Open sesame.
It's not working for me.
Oh, there goes Dr. Diggenstone. You know what? All of those were great ideas and we tried, but guess what? Seriously? Bibbidi bobbidi boo to open the famous temple doors to find treasure? I don't think that's gonna work. So guess what? You better come back tomorrow. Raise your hand, you're coming back tomorrow. Two hands if I'll see you tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow. And guess who's coming? Here comes Miss Jennifer.
We didn't find the true treasure yet, or did we? All right, did anybody listen to the Bible story? Today, we found out that God knows you and God hears you. Isn't that amazing to be known by God? Miss Jennifer's turn to talk. It's amazing to think that God knows us and He cares about us. And in our Bible story today, I need every adventurer to be quiet, please. We learned about a shepherd boy named David. And David did not really look like somebody who could be a king. Okay, my turn to talk. He was out there all alone with the sheep, just being a shepherd. Didn't seem like a very important job. But God had decided that David would be king. And then, what was the king's name that didn't like David? And Saul felt threatened by David. And so, he sent his men to chase after David. And David had to cry out to God. And God heard him. Who would like to tell us something about the Bible story today? Everyone needs to listen. This is really important.
Saul was trying to kill David.
Saul was trying to kill David. Somebody else over here in the blue shirt. Wait a minute, we're coming with a microphone. Every adventurer, please be quiet.
Saul was chasing David so he could die because Saul was afraid of David.
He was going to lose his kingdom, his being a king, right? And one more, Warren. You get to choose.
After David found, after Saul found David, a messenger came and told Saul that something was happening or something very bad was happening in the kingdom, so Saul had to turn back.
Very good. Thank you. Okay. All right, and then we learned a Bible verse today that helps us to remember that God hears us, okay? Let's say it together. It's up there, okay? Are you ready? Oh, Lord, you have examined my heart and know everything about me. Psalm 139, 1. Okay, one more time. Are you ready? Shh. Every adventurer. Here we go. Oh, Lord, you have examined my heart and know everything about me. Psalm 139, 1. Straight from the Bible, God's word. We can hide God's word in our heart. Okay, and I'm going to ask for two God sightings. Did we have any other God sightings? Right here. We're going to bring the microphone to you.
God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, and God the Father.
What did you say?
What's that again?
God the Holy Spirit, God the Father, and God the Son.
All right. Something that God did that you saw God show up today, right here.
Made a new friend.
You made some friends? That is a gift from God. Okay, Warren, choose one more. God sighting, something we saw God do. You got one? You can think about it for next time, okay? You want to think about it?
Okay. God loves me. God loves me.
Yes, he does. Okay, and then I have one more question for two people. What was your favorite part about Treasured Vacation Bible School today? In the pink shirt right there, peachy shirt. All right, every other adventurer, please be quiet.
Snack time.
Snack time? Yes. Okay, and over here in the pink dress, pink and white.
All right.
Your favorite part of Treasured VBS?
That we get to be here.
That you got to come, you liked everything? All right. Okay, we're gonna go back to our classrooms and we're gonna start with the fifth graders, but who's coming back tomorrow? All right.
I am a priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am his and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever.